awesome animals!
Hello, everyone. Today we'll be traveling to England and we'll be talking about the Airedale Terrier. Please don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos.
The Airedale Terrier originated in the Aire River Valley in England, where they hunted large rats. Airedales often competed in rat hunting contests, which attracted lots of spectators. Ferrets would be sent into rat burrows to flush out the rodents, and the Airedales would then chase them into the river. Originally bred to serve as a versatile hunting dog and all-around working farm dog, in Britain this breed has also been used as a war dog, guide dog, and police dog. In the United States, this breed has been used to hunt big game, upland birds, and waterfowl, and serve in many other working capacities.
The Airedale is a hard-working, independent, and athletic dog with a lot of drive, energy, and stamina. He is prone to digging, chasing, and barking, behaviors that come naturally to terrier breeds. You will be delighted with the Airedale's active, fun-loving, even comical attitude. The Airedale Terrier, which has an average lifespan of 10 to 13 years, sometimes suffers from colonic disease. Other serious health issues this breed is prone to include canine hip dysplasia, gastric torsion, and hypothyroidism. The Airedale Terrier is known as the King of Terriers, partly for his size. They range in height about 23 inches and in weight from 45 for a small female to 70 pounds for a large male. During World War I, the British military employed Airedale Terriers as sentries and couriers. Airedales carried messages between commanding officers and troops in the trenches. They also stood watch on the front lines and warned the troops when the enemy was approaching. The Red Cross also used Airedales as rescue dogs during the war. When Disney made a live-action version of 101 Dalmatians in 1996, they cast an Airedale Terrier in the role of Colonel, the wise old dog who helps Pongo and Perdita find their puppies. In the animated film, Colonel is an old English sheepdog, but the producers of the live-action film chose an Airedale instead, because they are so easy to train. John Wayne's nickname Duke actually came from his pet Airedale Terrier. When Wayne was a boy, he owned an Airedale named Duke that he would frequently take to visit the local fire station. The firemen would say, "Here come Big Duke and Little Duke." John Wayne was Little Duke. The nickname stuck with him for the rest of his life. The Airedale Terrier was arguably the most famous dog to ever live in the White House. The dog accompanied President Harding everywhere, from important cabinet meetings to golf games. Ever the media darling, Laddie Boy attended fundraising events, met celebrities, and wrote letters to the press. The Washington Star and the New York Times breathlessly followed every movement the beloved puppy made. Unlike some other dogs, Airedale Terriers don't leave a trail of fur wherever they go. Instead of continuous shedding, the dog shed just a few times a year. The canines have thick, bristly hair that needs occasional brushing to remove dead hair. Other than that, they really need one trip to the groomer per year. People living by the English Aire and Wharf rivers in the 1800s had a severe vermin problem. Animals like rats, foxes, and martens would burrow through the riverbanks and invade nearby fields. Exhausted and overrun villages worked to create the perfect dog to flush out the pests. A breed the right size to catch both a small rat and a large fox, capable of hunting on the ground or in the water.
When a British battalion was cut off by an enemy, they sent their Airedale Terrier Jack to deliver a message that they needed reinforcements. Despite being severely injured by shrapnel, Jack managed to deliver the message and save the battalion. Shortly after he completed his mission, Jack died from his injuries. He was posthumously awarded by the Victoria Cross, the highest honor in the United Kingdom. The Airedale Terrier was one of the first breeds to be used for police work. In Great Britain and Germany, given their bravery during the war, it's no wonder Airedales were tapped for police service.
If you've enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos. See you guys next time. Goodbye!